Good morning, boys and girls. Welcome to Shen Plays. Welcome to Golden Horde, Japan. That's right, Golden Horde has a huge chunk of Japan now after last episode's war with Ainu. And Twitch chat made a good point that when Ainu had his fleet over here dropping troops off in Izumo, it takes a month to get off the boats. I could have just walked up to Hokkaido. And I should have walked up to Hokkaido, but I'm a moron, so I didn't walk up to Hokkaido. But I should have done that for sure. Anyway, welcome back, everyone. Last episode, we also did a little bit of science. We found out that colonies will auto-finish if you annex everything else from that nation in the world, then their remaining colony will automatically finish. Although he doesn't start with a core there. Interesting. So Patani now lives in northern Philippines. Good for him. This episode is going to be about wars with Delhi and whoever else is in our way, perhaps Pasai. We'll see. But at least we are going to fabricate on Delhi. I want to take anything that's got like, 15 development. That sounds nice. We're going to take everything that's high development here. Ooh, 18 development in Khandesh. Don't mind if I do. And the whole point is simply to... Oh, right, my mission. Cancel my mission. I have a mission for Ming. Just get rid of it. The whole point is to burn everything down, get as many monarch points as possible, and just devour him. Just gobble him up. Oh, I can rival Poland. Done. So who hates Poland? Holland hates Poland. Holland, would you like an alliance? I'm going to work on an alliance with Holland. Ooh, Tech 20. You know, we're getting up there. Tech 23 is the second admin efficiency, which will make it even cheaper to core stuff, which means you can take even more land. I can't wait. I cannot wait. We got to get there, man. Danelle, I do get the graphics bug after playing for a while. Check out all my VODs, or all of my recent YouTube videos. We're getting the graphics bug every day. It's, I think it's just some type of memory leak. But I'm not sure. Anyway, let's get some troops marching over to Delhi. He's only got those sort of 30k troops. We shouldn't really have any trouble. I was positioning my armies for a war with Pasai, but apparently we have a truce with Pasai for another 3 years. So he'll have to wait. But in the meanwhile, we can definitely go beat up Delhi. So let's get some troops over there. We are colonizing two provinces in Taiwan and two provinces up here in the Ural Mountain area. It's very unfortunate that we have to colonize them, but we do have to colonize them for the Achievo, so we'll get to work on that. Establish cantonments, gain base manpower in Bagalpur, or two base manpower in Bagalpur. Sounds good to me. And yeah, we're stockpiling a whole buttload of cash so we can build the Suez Canal. Not that I need the Suez Canal, but let's build the damn thing. Why not? Also, keep fabricating on Ming. Where's your good land, Ming? 15, huh? 12, huh? 11, huh? 15 sounds good. Shaoxin? If I can fucking find it. Oh my god. Spell it for me. S-A-O. Okay, S, A, that one. There you go. It can be difficult finding these provinces sometimes. What else do I need? Well, I could go after Majapahit. I do. Should probably go ahead and claim Damak or something. Is that your capital? No. Where's your capital? Surabaya. Okay, let's claim Damak and let's go ahead and make him give that to me. And then from Damak, I can fabricate on the rest of the island. That's such a good province. I can fabricate on, like, everything from Damak. Rebels, where? Oh, it's zeros. Oh, Ottomans need help against Hungary. Who else is in the war? I mean, I'll help. Sure, put me in, coach. Lost a claim on Skuni. I don't care. I'm not actually going to help the Ottomans in this war. Oh my goodness. We have a force limit of 420. Let's build a couple more stacks. Wow. Let's build one here in Astrakhan. Build another one in Muscovy. Not Muscovy. Moskva. I forgot we renamed it to Moskva. And let's build another stack here in Persia. That's only 90,000 troops, though, but it's better than nothing. Now, ideally, the Ottomans would lose this war. I would love to see the Ottomans in trouble. Because I do plan on turning on him at some point. He's been the best ally ever. Because he doesn't really need our help for anything. He can do a lot of shit on his own. But I still want to see him fall on his face once in a while, right? It'd be fun. Yeah, that's a big army. Ooh, importers compete with Golden Horde quality goods. Lose mercantilism or gain mercantilism. Man, these choices. I like these choices. How much mercantilism do we have? 34 mercantilism as a horde. So nice. Also, we're keep doing culture changes down here. Keep it up. We're almost over to Mecca. All of this shit must be Russian culture. All shall be Russian. I think that's all we can do. I really wish we had this province. I really wish we had this province, Tadmor. Oh well. Didn't quite get it. And then do we want to keep pushing into India? I guess we should. Yeah, we need to push over into India and China with this wonderful Russian culture. Wow, we've gone through 400 points already? Don't worry, there's more. There's always more monarch points. Always, always, always. Points, huh? I guess we'll save a little bit. Ineffective missionary work in Tamathi. Oh, but it's at 97%. You know what? If we just stare at it, maybe it'll finish before this pop-up auto-triggers. Alright, come on. Expected to finish when? September. It's supposed to finish this month. I'm just going to ignore this pop-up. Come on, 99.8. Don't fuck up now. Yeah! Oh, now it goes to Naga. Aw, oh, shit. So if the one that was going to go finishes, then it goes to the next one. Okay. Still. It's nice that we got one finished. Oh, now it's Manipur. Oh, fuck you, game. It's just switched. I just canceled one and it just switched over to Manipur. Oh, man. And now it's Korat? Yeah. What if I cancel them all? What happens if I cancel them all? Now it's nothing. Oh, it doesn't happen anywhere. Okay, that's just weird. Whatever. Start them up again. I didn't know that. That's very weird. All right, come on, Ottomans. Ooh, tribes lose loyalty, but we gain 1,000 ducats? We're good on loyalty. Sort of good on loyalty. Alright, are we ready for the war over here? I think we are. We just got to get a mission, not a missionary, a diplomat back. Put my combat general here. Where's his main forts? Let's see, level 4, level 2, level 4, level 6, level 4, 6, 6. So he has 3 sixes. 1, 2, 3. So you can be my CG general. You're going to go over there. Ooh, a mission. Colonize Palu. Rival of rival Holland. I'll take that. Because I do want to ally Holland. I think. And you can be my combat general. And you can be a secondary combat general. Okay. There you go. Come on, lose, Ottomans, lose. I think he's losing. Yeah, he's losing. Good job, Ottomans. I knew you could lose. I knew you had it in you. All right, Delhi, you've had it too good for too long, my friend. Now, in this case, I am going to use imperialism because we want to take as much land as we possibly can. And imperialism will allow us to take 25% more land. It's the same thing we did with Ming. All right, get in there and start sieging these forts down. Get in there and do some combat and go siege that main fort. Is he gonna die here? Maybe. No, he's gonna get away. Okay, go siege his capital. And let us get relations up with Holland. There we go. Uh-oh. Is the interface going away already? That kind of sucks. Okay, that's one Delhi army dead. Let's go squish this one as well. I think he's going to Kandesh. Yeah. We should be able to squish him there. He'll get one more end of the month tick, I think. All of our cores are in. Okay, most of our cores are in. Oh, we found some salt in Tura. Very nice. We colonized salt. I love it. So appropriate. And he's dead. Okay, so let's go siege another fort. Now, since we declared imperialism war, this is what matters, is this capital fort. That's what you get ticking war score for the imperialism CB. Next fort. And at this point, he's going to build up some merc armies, which is fine. You know, the Ottomans are doing surprisingly well. They're not going to win their war, but they're doing surprisingly well. He's fighting Austria-Hungary, which is a massive... We haven't even looked at Europe in like 5 episodes. This guy is a massive beast. Austria-Hungary is nuts. They're very strong. Okay, Nizwa's done. Move on. What else can we culture convert? Not much. The only culture convert stuff that touches the green. And not much touches the green. Are any of these the right religion? Nope. You're the right religion. A lot of wrong religion stuff. That's the problem. Yep, we found salt in the colonies. Good times, right? What did we find down here? Fish. Dunno. And, yeah, salt and fur. So salt, fur, fish, and don't know yet. Oh yeah, look at him spam mercs. He's like, look at me, I have an army. I am of relevant. No, you are not of relevant, Delhi. You are of dead. He's in denial. Poland is no longer a valid rival. Well, then why'd you let me rival them just like a year ago? Okay, we got ticking war score now. I should probably hunt down these little armies, squish them. Stacks are done. Yep, we got 90k more troops, everyone. I could help out a little bit. We currently have 0% participation. I don't really feel like helping out, though. I want Ottomans to lose. Let's get some more claims on Ming. Let's claim more of his coastline. Ciao, ciao. What else can I claim? Oh, I got my claim on Majapahit? I did. All right, we'll go demand Damoc from him. Mamluks, how you doing on development? Oh, he's got Keen up to 25 development. You know what, Mom Lukes? I think I will eat some of your land. I can't believe he's got 25 development here. He is actually trying. He's trying to rebuild. He's like, you know what? The only way I can communicate through the world to the rest of the world is if I talk to the Golden Horde and they're generous enough to allow me to, you know, buy some goods. Maybe I want to buy some chocolate from the New World, or maybe I need some iron, or maybe I need some spices, or maybe I need some fish or something. But the only way he can communicate with anyone is through us. And he's still trying. Look at that, 25 development. And 14 over here in Asyut. Yeah, he's really putting some effort in. Good on you, Mamluks. What in the world, Deimos? What is that sound, Deimos? Uh-oh, is it hairball time? Oh, it's hairball time. Deimos is getting frisky with the... Cruelty of mercenaries, go away. I'll keep you up to date on the hairball situation. Currently, though, he's just looking at me like I'm stupid. Which, granted, he may be right. Well, we found your army, Deli. We found your Merc army. Wow, the war just started. We already have 54 war score. It's pretty good. All right, Lucknor is done. Is that Lucknor? Yeah, Lucknor. Let's head to Lucknow, unseat some of this shit. Lost our marriage with the Ottomans again. Goodness gracious. Oh, he's in a regency council. Good times. Yeah, this could be great. If the Ottomans are forced to, like, I don't know, release Bulgaria or something, that'd be amazing. Since Cigar is done. He has one more fort up here. But I think before we siege that fort... Yeah, we should go get the level 6 first. There's a level 6 down here, which makes more sense. Well, no, because we're already at 81 war score. Might as well just siege the provinces I want to peace out with. With the Imperialism CV, everything costs 0 Diplo points. So it doesn't really matter what we want to take, everything just costs 0. Wow, you survived that? Really? Wow. Okay. Unsiege all this shit, please. When this fort falls, we should be able to peace out. I think. Although I might want to siege... Let's see. I'm going to siege these provinces that are highlighted because they have high development, and it's going to cost us a little bit less in the peace deal to get those provinces if I have claims on them. I mean, if I've sieged them. Sieging him down makes a little cheaper in the peace deal cost. So let's go do that. I think I wanted Panipat and Dahundar. Ah, another fort down. Okay, go next door. /99 war score, yeah. So to seize these last couple provinces, we'll peace out. There's no more forts we need to finish. This siege is unnecessary. Anything else I want in the peace deal? Let's see. High development stuff. Might as well siege down the stuff that's orange. All right, that should be good enough. When these two sieges finish, we'll peace out. Start coring all this shit. Oh, another fort done. Nice. All right, let's peace out. Oh, I don't have a diplomat. Oh, shit. Come on back from Holland? No. Stay in Holland. Stay until January and then come back. Okay, January 1st, come on back. Oh, we got another fort. Didn't need it, but okay. Oh, Panipat. He took Panipat back. Jerk. Nah, whatever. Just peace out. Doesn't matter. All right. Sort by overextension cost. Let's take the highest development shit. And again, we're going to get right up to the 100 war score cost. And okay, maybe instead of Lochnor... Panipat, and maybe Katahur, Sirhind. That looks nice. And then whatever we can't keep, after burning it all down, we'll just release stuff that we can't keep. But yeah, we're taking the riches out of his land. Lovely. Step one, goodbye forts. Step two, goodbye more forts. I think that's all the forts we took. Yeah. Step three, burn it all down. 19 developments? Oh, sounds more like 150 monarch points. Thank you. Monarch points. Ooh, monarch points. Oh, oh, ooh, oh. 175 monarch points. That's just so good. Give me the monarch points, baby. Yeah, that's the stuff. Whip it, kick it. Yeah, that's the ticket. All right, is that everything burned down? I think it is. Burnt, 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 burnt. Extra crispy, super crispy, original recipe. Yeah, it's all burnt. We're all good. Everything's burned down. Now, how much OE is that? It says 134, which is what it said before we burnt anything down. I don't believe that for a fucking second. I do want to keep Delhi, so let's go ahead and core that. Now, what's it say? 92. Oh, we can keep it all. We can keep all of it. The burning was a great success. A resounding success. We get to keep all of it. Well, let's get the autonomy up. And core everything. How much does it cost to core this shit? 32 points. It's like nothing. It's like not 32 points for all this shit. It's so cheap. 52 points. Okay, well that one's a little more pricey, but still. Wow. So cheap. Good feeling when you actually get to keep all the land you take. That was 100% war score with imperialism CB, which was 136 overextension, but we burnt it down to like 90 something overextension. That's great. 136 burnt down to 92. That's fantastic. Make sure the autonomy's done. Looks pretty good. Autonomy looks good. And all the cores are coming in. Yep. Okay. Truce is up with Ming Wen. 6 years? Ugh. Alright, I guess for now we can just watch the Ottomans fall. Yes. Constantinople's falling. I love it. Get out of here, Delhi. You cannot have access. Ooh, culture conversions. I like it. Oh, are we going to get to Mecca today? Not today. We're getting close, though. We're one province away from Mecca. Being Russian culture. Gotta love it, man. We're getting a lot of work done. Keep converting. Can we get into China? Oh, I bet we can get China converted to Russian. I bet we can do it. Just gotta put your mind to it, man. God, that's gonna take some time. Yeah, I know it's time. I know. We got Delhi. Where's his capital now? Capital is Bundelkund. Nice. Good for you, Delhi. Oh, look at this. Look at this glorious situation. The Ottomans are fucking collapsing. I wonder if they care. I wonder if you lose points with them. Like, if you lose trust. If you don't help them in their war. Because I'm not going to fucking help them. Oh, Constantinople fell. Oh, that's so good. We still have 0% participation. Oh. It's not like he's super weak or anything. He's outmatched, you know, he's outnumbered. And he expected us to help and we're not helping. Wow, look how big Tuscany is. Holy shit. All right, we've allied Holland. I like it. Finished our mission. What's the next mission? Conquer Kuching. Where's Kuching? I assume it's in Ming somewhere. It is not in Ming. It's in Brunei. Okay. I guess I can do that. Okay. Free claim. Are you trying to tell me something? Are you trying to tell me that I need to fabricate on Brunei? Because I'll do it. I'll fucking do it, man. I think first and foremost, though, we should probably end this episode here. Come back next time to find out what happens in the war between the Ottomans, Hungary, Tuscany, and Milan. Milan has taken over Venice. He's kind of migrated. And Tuscany just is hugely dominant. I think Tuscany needs Milan and Rome, and then he can form the nation of Italy. But good luck getting Milan. Anyway, come back next time for further adventures in the lands of the Golden Horde. Yeah, I thought this was Aragon for a minute, but it's not Aragon. It's Hungarian Italy. Look at that shit. What's going on in Europe? I'll see you guys next time. Oh, toothpaste still lives. Toothpaste lives in Burgundy. Does he still have all his cores? He's got some of his cores. Toothpaste used to be huge. Remember when toothpaste was big? And no one likes toothpaste anymore. All right, I'll see you guys later. Bye-bye.